What is going on, everybody? Mr. Burger here. We are back with some more song reactions. Took the last week off. It was spring break. We got a new puppy as well, so I kind of took the break off last week to kind of relax and just kick back and stuff like that. But we are back with it today, and we are finally back with some more of The Warning. It's been a couple weeks, probably, I think, since we listened to them. And this one's a bit interesting, because we are reacting to a cover of a song that they did. And I don't know that I've reacted to covers of songs on this channel. I might have done one or two, but generally I try to stick to an artist's original material, more or less. But what's intriguing to me with this one, and the main reason that I'm doing this specific song next, is this is a cover of a Foo Fighters song, and not just any Foo Fighters song. This is a cover of one of my favorite Foo Fighters songs, The Pretender. Apparently they absolutely kill it in this video, which I have no doubt in my mind that they do. And what's interesting is this video is 4 years old. Actually, it's about 5 years. It's 5 years old. Oh yeah, 5 years old at this point. Oh, and it came out of my birthday. Look at that. But their ages in this video are 11 years old up to 15 years old. Like none of them, at least in Virginia, none of them can legally have a driver's license yet. And they're out here killing it, I'm guessing, with one of my favorite songs. Not just by the Foo Fighters, probably of all time. I just love this song so much. So that is exactly what we are doing today. But before we do get into this, guys, if you could please drop a like on the video, hit that subscribe button, hit that bell icon, and comment down below what other songs you guys would like for me to react to. And I actually just realized I never put the comments on the screen of the people that requested this one. Specifically, it was Adam and Mad Dog. So thank you both for suggesting these. Those comments will be up now if they are not already. And yeah, so let's go ahead. Let's get into this. Super excited. The Warning, The Pretender, a cover of Foo Fighters. Not sure with this video, like they're outside, and I guess the title of this video is Out of the Basement. From I guess that was what they usually would do. I'm not sure if this is being performed live here on this hill, or if they're just doing like the music video kind of thing and they're playing along to the song while they're recording the video. It kind of sounds like they are doing this live on this hill. But I'm not 100% sure, and I don't think the description of the video mentioned it. Yeah, the video doesn't mention if this is actually live or not, if they're just doing like a video for it. So far, very good though. Wife needs me to open the door. I will be back momentarily. And just like that, we are back with the song. Or listening to the song. I think we had just gotten into the verse. It's actually kind of... I'm gonna say weird, but not weird in a bad way. listening to this song without two guitar parts going. Like, the bass is playing the root notes for the chords, but generally at this point in the song, you know, there's the lead guitarist that she's doing. It's like the na 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 na. But then the other guitar is doing like na 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 na, like that kind of thing. So it's odd, I guess. Again, not in a bad way, just kind of like, I don't know, I just never heard it with only one guitar part before, or at the very least that they chose the lead part over the rhythm part to be the only guitar part. It's just interesting. Man, they make me want to pull out my Chris Shiflett telly right there. He's a lead guitarist for Foo Fighters, and just play the song again. I haven't played this song in years. Maybe not years, but it's been a long time since I played this song specifically. I mean, like, they're doing really, really good here, especially for their ages. Like, they're killing it for how old they are. But it's amazing. I mean, so this is like the oldest thing from them that we've listened to now at this point. Most of the other stuff that we've listened to from them was no more than 2 years old, I think. Maybe three at the most. Like 2018, 2019 at the oldest, I believe. But I think most of the stuff was like late 2019, early 2020 kind of stuff. They are so little in this video. And, I mean, just in, like, 5 short years, they've gotten so much better. Like, again, they're really good here, but they've gotten just absolutely incredible over the last few years. Looking at, like, this one versus, I think it was, which ones did we do? I don't remember off the top of my head what songs we've listened to from them already. But they've just gotten so good. So, so good. Oh, I just lost what I was going to say. Oh, crap. What was I going to say? I don't think this is what's, but something else that I had just thought of is she actually, for especially at 15, like, she can get a good, like, kind of growl, gravelly sound out of her voice. Like, the, that was bad. but, like, bite, that's what it is. She can add some bite to her voice at only 15. That's really impressive. Yeah. Okay, so I'm about to get like to one of the most screamy parts of this song in probably about, what, 15-ish, 20 seconds maybe? I'm looking very forward to seeing how she handles that, because that'll be really cool. Something also that I'm just curious to find out the reasoning behind is their bassist. Again, this video is only 11 years old, so she probably doesn't have much smaller hands than I do. I have very, very tiny hands. I find it interesting that she's actually using a Gibson SG bass. And unless, I'm not exactly sure to the guitar neck profiles of Gibson's basses, but if it's like their guitars, typically they have a bit of a fatter neck. So I'm curious, I wonder how easy it is for her to play that bass versus going with like a Fender one that typically has a slimmer neck profile, which like my one right there. I mean, it doesn't seem to be slowing her down at all. I'm just curious if how easy it is for her to play that one, just with how probably how thick the neck is on that. Yeah, that part pretty good, especially for a 15-year-old. She did that part really, really good for the growly part of it. Yeah, that was nice. She did that really, really good. Something interesting that I actually didn't notice until the end of the video. Where is it? Where in the song? It's near the end here. Just wanted to double check. It's a close-up of her, the front of her guitar. Oh, right there. Oh, come on, it was right there. Okay, so I was right. Interestingly, I don't know that... They might have, and I just don't know. Gibson's made a lot of Les Pauls over the years. But these actually had Seymour Duncan pickups on them, which are very, very popular humbuckers to put on electric guitars. Especially in, like... rock, punk, metal kind of genres. So I'm curious then if she got, if, okay, I guess a few things. If the Les Pauls when she that she has came with Seymour Duncan pickups, if she got the Les Paul and then had someone, or maybe she put it on, I don't know, put Seymour Duncan's in it, or she bought the guitar secondhand and it came with the Seymour Duncan's. That's interesting. I mean, you know, guitar nerd head here and me coming out. But I don't know, that's just interesting. They definitely have a unique sound. But that was really, really good. I guess the only sort of complaint I quote unquote have, and it's not really much of a complaint, is that I think this is a song that definitely benefits from having that second guitar going through the verses, and probably near the end of the bridge with where it's the da na 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 na, that part, having the rhythm guitar doing like its thing for those parts, I think is actually really essential to this song. So it kind of made the verses sound a tad bit empty sounding without it, but it was still really, really good. I mean, you know, there's only three of them, so you can't have, you know, one person playing two guitars at the same time. But I mean, other than that, like I said, really, really good song, especially with how young they were in this. Again, 11, 13, and 15. Just absolutely incredible. The singer had the nice bite to her voice when she needed it, and you know, Foo Fighters would be absolutely proud of this song. But yeah, so that will be it for today, guys. I hope you did enjoy this just as much as I did, and I will see you all in the next one. Take care, guys.